I'm Dave Hewlett here at Renwood Farms. I'm a grower in Charles City County, farm with my dad, and have two brothers at a farm with Johnny and Jeff. And we crop around 4,000 plus acres all along the banks of the James River here in Eastern Virginia. When you think of growing corn, you sure don't think of Virginia. You know, you think of the Midwest states. We take great pride in their products, and we have great challenges, as you could imagine, with the environments, but we strive to produce high yields. We've kind of had goals in place, and as we've been cropping some ground at Curl's Neck Farms, you know, we've tapped into some areas of the land that's more productive. Curl's Neck used to be a big dairy operation, so there were areas that had more organic matter than other areas. And in those areas that we were able to identify, we said, well, let's see if we can push a little bit harder. And then through some irrigation management, through some cultural practices, through the application of some our products, that we've been able to unleash some of the yield potentials.
My name is Phil Hickman. I'm the executive director of the Virginia Corn Board, which is an affiliate with the National Corn Growers Association. On September 16th, 2013, David Hewlett with Renwood Farms broke the world corn yield on this farm here in Henrico County, Virginia.
The night before we started doing the official checks, you know, I took the harvester up there, or the combine, and we started opening up the field. And then, you know, we had the yield monitors in the combine, so we were able to see what we're producing real time. And then when you start seeing the numbers on that monitor tap into areas that you've seen previously but not as consistent, you know, that kind of gets your heart going a little bit, because now you're into something.
The yield monitor would spike up quite frequently over 500 bushels, and I asked David if that was correct. Had he calibrated the monitor? And he said, yes, it was correct.
We were able to harvest 454 bushels of corn per acre there at Curl's Neck. Philip Davis and BioVent, they've been huge in helping us maximize their potential. It's been fun to see how we can improve upon their soil, improve upon their plant health, and get returns on their, not just their investment, but just get returns to where we can help their whole system here at the farm. By using some of the BioVent products, like the BioRed, which helps stimulate some of the organisms in the soil, and then we use some other products, BioMate being one, it's like a sugar source for them, you know, just to help feed the organism in the soil. And it's allowed us to take some poor productive soils and just make them more fertile. Whenever we're doing these plots, we always like to have a comparison to see if what we've done has been working. So we dedicate one area to where it's just not, doesn't get all the treatments, and it's kind of like a control. And this past year, where we did the complete program from the seed to the BioVent products to air water management, air aerial applications, and air irrigation, we had a yield of 437 bushels. And then where we had our control, which didn't have any of the BioVent products, or very few of them, we had a yield of 373 bushels there. So, you know, yeah. There was a significant difference between the two. We try something new every year. Now, some of it works, some of it doesn't. But then when you tap into a company or somebody that you have a great relationship with, you know, they steer you in a direction and you just try something new. And you'll see the results, and some are positive. We've gone backwards a lot of times, but we're on a steady growth upwards. So that's the exciting part.